and being surveyed, have you ever asked yourself, how do we buy things from Nakasero Market? I happened to pass there recently. Bananga chiriyari, wawunya! Na yepa serebintu, amantuba judeo.
You pass this direction, and so where wa no wetako wano, watermelon ezivunze, ebikuta biebikajo.
There is too much that. Now, that confused me because when I was leaving my home to come to Nakasero Market, I passed by Suburbia in Kololo, up there where people live in their gates. They don't even know what is outside their gate. Ngo mkazi wa kesi si aliyawa yera kubo. Then I'm asking myself, kesi si muli kuchi? Why are you sending people to Suburbia to clean up streets that are in a residential area that has probably shamba boys and gardeners who clean up? And you cannot clean up in city center. And then I ask myself, now of course somebody's going to be like, but there's nothing much they can do, but damn. How do we even buy things here? Ah, tell Ugandans how those chicks have attitude. Nyame nyanya za meka. Situnda za alukumi wabate wakala agenda.
What the hell, man? Wali waunya no kunya. Just think about it, man. Kesi siye tulibako. Before you begin evicting people and doing all these drives and all of this nonsense, please clean up Nakasero Market. It's disgusting. And it is in city center. At home of China, nobu yindi wabu wa.
There are many, many Indians and Chinese people on that street.
It is, anyway, the whole situation confuses me. Where was I? Welcome to Scoop and Scoop. My name is Tina. So Wizkid I took to his own. Anyway. Apparently, there is rumor that WizKid could want to come and give us 2 free shows.
Aww,
WizKid. The moment I heard this, so many things went through my mind. I looked at the variables, I looked at so many facts, but then I asked myself, hold up, WizKid, do I look stupid to you? So you're telling us that you're going to come, give us 2 free shows, because you cancelled the most previous one, and you think Ugandans are going to sit pretty and be like, ah, yes, WizKid. No, first of all, you need to explain to us what free means. Does free show mean you're going to come and put a show at like 20K? Kubanga faba na Uganda tuwako wabishob yo were 20,000 is not a show. Rane Kamilion agenda kulonchingano, we're going to be giving him 100K. Bebe Cool pays 3 million for a table, and you're telling us what?
You're going to make us pay like 20K, 10K?
And if it's free, because I know free ain't free really in Africa. If it's free, who is going to pay for the rest of the stuff? Then it hit me. No! WizKid is just going to come to Uganda, give you 2 days of free shows, and guess what you're going to be, Ugandans? You're going to be one of those people in a video that are screaming in a background stage like, you know that video of his he has where he's in Guinea-Bissau and he's somewhere else. Baba gendo bako la mwajo bako bamu bivuru. Bivuru bienere, teni kalala kavayo. And besides, Wizkid, do you think we cannot afford to pay for your show if you managed to disappoint us the first time and we had bought your tickets in plenty? You think we cannot afford to come for your show? But then there's another question. What makes you honestly believe that Ugandans are actually going to come out by the numbers and by what? Because you said it's free. What will the campus girls tell their friends like, did you go for WizKid? Like, you went for free stuff? Not me. I was at the Serena chilling, and then we passed by, I don't know, we went for Jose Chameleon's show, we paid like 200K to get... Do you get what I'm saying? Like, this is... in simple terms, first of all, your boy, you don't show up for the first one. Then you think to make it right, you're going to make us sound like cheapskates by telling us you're giving us a free show. So what? Ugandans are supposed to be somewhere just wild in ecstasy and happy that, oh my goodness, WizKid is coming for us. No. Chameleon has a concert at Tulindegwe. This guy started doing music before you were born. You want us to sit and wait for you? A guy who is doing a lot of bubblegum nonsense? Boy, bye. If you don't want to janaga imbago te ganyumanze, nalabiaga imbaga WizKid, go nagari augach. Siru, tagaina magezi, you have your Chris Brown wannabe. What? You want to talk to your Nigerian friends? Like when you go back, you're like, were you in Kampala? And then Patro Ranking is going to be like, no, guys don't know now. And they get there, and they speak Patois, they just arrest me. Then you can stand there and be like, aha, abego, when I went to Uganda, the rich, they come in the studio very full, full, full. We'll look like the bigger idiots. So Ugandans, I know this is a part where I can't say muteke center we mulaba, ne muteke muku magezi. This guy is going to rip you off. You're going to actually be a bigger joke than you were the first time. Think about it. I'm not boycotting him. God knows I can listen to that deal.
So, I don't usually like to talk about people's situations, but
I happened to watch this video of Palazzo shirtless. I don't know what the hell you were saying because I was lost in translation. I didn't know what you were saying, really. But you were very naked and you were sweaty and... All I can say is that the person who sent me this shot of you was like, ne Palazzo alibichi. As in, I'm confused, Palazzo. Lately, your music has been... It's trying to go somewhere. I was shocked that people actually love Palazzo's Mama song. And the Walolos have come down on Twitter, but there is nothing. But this, I can talk about your situation. So, I don't know if it's true, but it looks like it's true because I checked out the site and yes, truth is, the so-called big mansion that is owned by Ivan Ssemwanga is up for sale. Banan. Zakakati wanu we being confusing. Ivan! I know everybody who has seen this has begun saying, oh, it's Ivan Ssemwanga running broke, is he doing this? I'm not going to take that angle, because I'm tired of knowing Ivan's financials. He clearly doesn't know how to manage those. But the questions I have. So this house is up for sale. You claim it's your house. Whenever we call out Ivan Ssemwanga for not having a house and always doing this and that, this is the same house he puts up. But if you guys ever notice, enyumba tajia kubiranga kumbifana nyechiru. All the photos of Ivan Ssemwanga at that house are broad daylight. And then you have to also put into consideration the fact that the moment Ivan Ssemwanga jets into this country, he never goes to his house. He goes to the Serena Riyabayonga Bamubanja Bubinyo. Nasasula. So I have questions, very many. Then I'm just perturbed. Is the house yours or is it the truth that it is owned by your brother who pretty much has curfew rules and told you Bobango ze Uganda was where that sawa nyeze chirongo batona dasigala yo. I mean, I'm just that would even seem what on a guy tatubulia. That house was never his, and this is what I keep telling people. Ugandan socialites /celebrities lately all they do is show money. Everybody who wants a photo op, it's like being on Instagram. This is why I'm not on the gram. The gram is a place where everybody goes to floss and then come back to their lives and live reality in a totally, totally different way. Now, this guy keeps telling us, you know, Simanya, and this house is mine. It cost me this much money to build. Why would you, a sane, regular person, honestly, leave the country for months on end, then come back and still not manage to go and live in your house? Meanwhile, where was he staying with Zari? Weren't they renting? And he claims he has a house, a mansion that has Simanya swimming pool, 6 bedrooms, 5 bathrooms. That house never, ever, ever, ever belonged to Ivan Ssemwanga. This is where I actually understood that maybe Sentong was... The end of his life was going to come if he had actually really stayed with these boys. Because maybe Sentong actually has some... But King Lawrence oloze wabwe baine nyumba. Bamwa genda kuserena na kwati laiba kazi nga Juliana na abajuki zambu. They are still young and alive. Honestly speaking, stop lying to the public, Ivan Ssemwanga. You prove us wrong. Please, prove us wrong. I will humbly sit up here and tell you, I am sorry. Bring out the paperwork that shows that that house is yours. See yo! So the BAFTA Awards are up again, and Eddie Kenzo, our very own Eddie Kenzo, mama, you know, Mwogera, weren't you? That is the best export we have. He's been nominated alongside people like Ali Kiba, Diamond Platnumz, WIZKID, you have the likes. Big shots are in this whole thing, part of ranking. Now, in my head, I was like, oh, Eddie Kenzo, please prove to us that you can bring back another international award, or not just international, okay, another award. Any other award, bring it home. Because let's give him some reasonable doubt. Yes, his music sucks. It really does. But his videos, they're beautiful. Can't the communities out there realize this about Eddie Kenzo and only nominate him in regards to his videos? My goodness, we would have Grammys, Oscars, would have it all at home. His videos are sublime. Meanwhile, in the same situation there, the BAFTA Awards, we have Joseph Mayanja, aka Chameleon, has been put up alongside the legends in music. You have people like Fela Kuti, Yvonne Chaka Chaka, Mubamtado, Mokakati, Nebamalajimua, because it's under music legend. Imagine if Chameleon won that. Muna Mudawa. Olaba Yagenda Nabagamba, he's number 6 in Africa before he even had a number on that list. Anyway, but that's it. Let's pray for our people to bring back any award, anything. Not that we are waiting for much. Eddie Kenzo, you won't get it, but if you do, I'd be glad. There's nothing much to say. And how could I forget the highlight of my busting is award moment? Bruno K. Na kugamba sigara ku birthday parties is a wamanyira. But no, you wanted to force it upon you and us that we're a real solidified artist. I didn't know. Is he an artist? Is he a cover artist? But oh well, things didn't go quite as planned for Bruno K at the Bastini's Awards. I'm standing there. They call Bruno K up on stage. And he comes in and is like, kids, I'm going to do Shape of You by Ed Sheeran. The moment he said that, I was like, but why? But why would you do this to us? Now, he starts the song and he only knows pretty much 2% of the song, and he's just saying everything but the part where I was like, God help us shoot this boy. His French cut is annoying, his face is more annoying, but his performance made me want to drive a stake right through his heart. And he starts, everybody join me, ooh, 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 ooh. Let's start. Ooh, 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 ooh. What the hell were you even thinking? Okay, it's a bad look, son. It's a bad look. To a point, then it was funny, now it's not funny. Like, it's not making me laugh anymore. It's just plain annoying. Stop showing up for performances. Stop trying hard to become an artist if you cannot follow up with an artist. Oh, you know, bukulemyo kuseringa. Now even the opportunity you get to sell your song, you come on stage and you sing Ed Sheeran's Shape of You. Really? How cliche can one person be? You are like the biggest cliche they ever was. And please, that French cut of yours is so bloody annoying. I wish I could jeer you in another language, but I can't. Ugh, you're disgusting. You're actually disturbing. You're not just disgusting, you're disturbing. Blech. Where was I? And on that very annoying, nauseated note, I would love to say, it's been my time. Catch me again tomorrow. At TinaFierce1 is my Twitter handle. And you can always go to Facebook, that's the Scoop and Scoop Facebook page. Or better yet, YouTube. We have our uploads and they're always going on and on and on and on and on. For now, I'm out. Peace.